The Chinese Communist Party get angry when people want to know the truth. What are they thinking? You know, do they think that we don't have a brain?
Carrie Lam is very much a puppet.
中共近期强行通过香港国安法后，持续引发国际关注，不同国家也开始展开制裁或救援香港的行动。在这支影片里，我们请英国和澳洲的同事上街采访民众，询问他们对香港局势的看法，一起来看看。
Well, the Chinese Communist Party get angry when people want to know the truth. This is the problem. What are they thinking? You know, do they think that we don't have a brain? You know, this is ridiculous. And people have the right to know what has gone on. I'm very angry about this.They have every right in the world to fight for their freedom. Not only that, but the fact that they were not allowed to wear masks and things like that, I think is disgusting. And they are getting arrested and getting beat up and we're called hooligans or barbarians or something or terrorists. How ridiculous. The Chinese Communist government really need to get with the program.
It's absolutely outrageous from the point of view of us here in a democracy. It goes against us. It goes against the agreements we're put in place. And I fully support the government on allowing and making it easier for British passport holders to come here.
Carrie Lam is very much a puppet, and I think she, you know, she's the puppeteer of the Chinese government. So she's in a very difficult position. I think, you know, even if we did do sanctions, is it sanctions against Carrie Lam or is it sanctions against China? And I think, you know, the bigger thing is sanctions against China. And, you know, yesterday,The English government took a big step with changing the approach to having Huawei provide us with 5G. And I think, you know, maybe it's the start of something bigger against China. Who knows?
I think the people of Hong Kong had every reasonable expectation that after the end of British occupation, which is fundamentally what it was, the colonial period, that the agreement that was struck up between Hong Kong and China would be ongoing. But of course, over the last 15 years, and most particularly over the last 2 years, China has systematically, through smaller and then larger moves, taken away a lot of that sovereignty and much of Hong Kong's autonomy. And I think the people of Hong Kong didn't agree to that, and that is fundamentally anti-democratic.
I think they're very brave.I think they're very brave, and I think it shows great passion for Hong Kong. You know, it's always been a gem, Hong Kong. It's got a lot of international investment, a lot of foreign businesses. It's always been well respected. It's a very well regarded part of the world. A lot of people love to stop there and enjoy it. So, yeah, I think it's really sad. I've got friends who live there, who work there, who love it. It would be a tragedy if they destroyed that.
My thoughts on the situation of Hong Kong are, why don't we take it back?I'm sure that there's somewhere in the treaty that was signed with China that you can take back Hong Kong. And you'll have to do some research, but yeah, I'm pretty positive. There's got to be something there that the UK can turn around and do something with regards to what's happening in Hong Kong.
Can you tell me your name?
Unfortunately, my name is David Potter. No relation to Harry.
I think there's many people who would agree.There's a very strong case for Carrie Lam to be included on the list. I know, for example, my former leader of the Conservative Party, Ian Duncan Smith, and former Labour Minister, Chris Bryant, who actually almost became the Speaker of the House of Commons, they are both quite vocal that Carrie Lam should be included on the list for this crackdown. I think crackdown is a bit of a genteel word to use, this crackdown in Hong Kong, this...breaking of international treaty, of international laws, of firm, sacred commitments given to the people of Hong Kong, and indeed the world, lodged in the United Nations. And she has become, frankly, I'm a Yorkshireman, I call a spade a shovel. She's become a stooge of the Forbidden Palace. So yes, I would very strongly support that Carrie Lam's name be considered amongst those who have committed terrible atrocities.
最后再来看看他们有哪些话想对香港人说。
I wish the Hong Kong people all the best in their look for justice. Simple as that.
Come here. Come here. We will look after you. You have the freedom. You should have the freedom.
I've had the great pleasure and the privilege of spending quite a lot of time in Hong Kong over the years. It is a remarkable place and the people are so warm and friendly. I understand why they're angry, and I understand why they're prepared to fight for independence, freedom, and self-autonomous government. Because without those things and the spirit of democracy that underpins them, you don't have Hong Kong as the world's come to enjoy it. I think the Chinese government would be well advised to reconsider its position. Surely there's a position of negotiation that could have been taken rather than simply imposing this decision from outside.